Hi folks, welcome to another episode of Firewood Doctor. Today's video is just the chucking of rounds. There's no music, it's in real time of all the rounds bucked, except maybe a dozen or so, from the three videos of how long can each chainsaw run on a tank of fuel. It turns out at my rate of speed, the chucking takes as long as the bucking. So, yeah, comment away, and I do have some commentary during the video, so enjoy the show.
Thank you. Oh. Yeah, working in this summer heat is not a lot of fun, but I'm managing the heat stress that I go through so I can get more work done in a day, or get any work done for that matter. There are some weekends when problems set in, I can't get any work done. I'm just sitting in the house doing nothing. At least now I can get work done. Now that once I get these rounds out of the way and those stringers bucked, I won't have to build the Great Wall of Cherry. The whole point of this series of videos is to show the real work that goes into firewood and how much time it actually takes when you're trying to manage your heat related issues, whatever they may be. Could be just general heat stress, which I do by, you know, working for 20-25 minutes, then taking a break. So I've been trying it out, run the saw until I can't safely buck the log pile anymore. Now this one, I got the stringers totally uncovered. So, and then I'll roll the stringers over and finish cutting through them. And then I could just chuck rounds. I don't have to stack them up like I said anymore. Not getting as many barbecue chunks off the end of each log like I thought. As if there's going to be an inch or so on some of these, I just make it a 17 or 18 inch piece. Like this one, I screwed up cutting. I cut some pieces short. This, whatever harvester processes is pretty accurate. By the time you take an inch or two off for the cut of the saw and being a little bit off, even a half inch off, you're going to end up without a cookie on the ends of these. I'm about to disrupt the camera view if I keep stacking wall up any higher over here. Normally I do hyperlapse, But I just wanted to do this series to show how much work it is. That one hung up in the tongs. Went to release and it caught it. Whew. tongues didn't want to release on that one. Thank you. start moving my camp up before it gets buried. If you made it this far, this video is about showing you how much work firewood is. I took all these video segments out of the normal chainsaw videos to show the extra work that tossing rounds out of the way is in real time, so you have a better understanding of the actual work involved. Really? There's my one of my favorite firewood tools. This and the log tongs has been big saving grace in getting work done in firewood when it's hot. I don't know if I'm going to do any more work today after chucking these rounds out of the way. It's already almost 76 degrees with like 90-91% humidity right now. Which is a lot stickier than it was before the last video segment of chucking. Now, this one's a cut a bit long. A little on the short side. No wonder some of my cookies are in the large side. But I'm not going for bundle grade here. I'll definitely get a processor at some point, but then I'll need a tractor, or I'm going to be rolling the logs to the log lift. That'll mean a different wood yard setup. Oh, at least he didn't roll the wrong way too far. That one just hung on to the tongs. That rolled to the correct side of the pile. Ooh. Well, I lost the shade here now. Whoops. That one was pretty green. So, I mean, these logs are so light. There. Well, that's it, folks, for this video of how long does it take to do the chuck small rounds out of the way, at least lightweight rounds. This cherry is pretty light compared to that oak. I'd rather chuck this all day than that stuff. One, it's smaller. Two, per cubic foot, feels like half the weight. So till next time, folks, take care, get out there, do something, have fun doing it, stay hydrated.